a little bit about measurements. So that's also, especially don't like think about when you look at measurements, then it's just, it's some people who had measured some birds like you have done, and then they put down your measurements like. And that is also, so that's important to like look at how many samples have they had. So if they like, maybe here they had 79 samples of lesser capybara, how would it look if they had 200? Then maybe maximum minimum will be a little high. So it's, so look how many samples. If they have taken 5 birds, then maybe don't trust as much to it. So, and the Svensson, they have like 15, the sample size is 15. So to use some of those where the sample is higher. And you can see here, capybara, wing length, the median is 69 and a half. Between 62 and 77. Yeah. And when we look at our own data, I just quickly just looked at our data from this summer. So if you, until like, if you are in the summer here, then in June, July, August, then you know, okay, the birds, they are lesser red poles in this time of year. The flamere don't come here so early. So that is lesser. Unless there's a flamere who has fucked up a bit and then just flown together with some others and come back and be a totally different place. But yeah, in general, you can say this these birds in the summer, early autumn is lesser red poll capybara. And then you can see the wing length out here. Now you can see our maximum this summer was a bird with 77 weight, and it's actually a male, it's an adult male also, so it's very easy recognizable as lesser red pole also. So, and then it comes down like two with 76, and some with 75, and many with 74. And mealy red pole is not a problem, like many of them have 74, 75. So that is quite a big overlap. So trust, especially on what you see on the bird, the coloration and structure. Yes, okay. Less I have a shorter wing in general, a lot of overlap. It actually also fit with our measurements. I think 62, that must have been some birds where they haven't grown out the wings yet. That sounds very sure. Yes. Mealy red pole slightly bigger, but you can see it range from 70 to 81, and it's very common they have like 73, 74. It's not usual. So yeah, the Greenland or dark Iceland, that is the rostrata. So here they have put them together. The dark ones from Iceland is rostrata, they say, or they put it in the same group. As the one from Greenland, so that is rostrata, and there you can see they are bigger in general, fitting actually 78. That is quite close to our to Sverige on Iceland. He also, the medium was also 78 in wing here. So, but if you have a bird like with 84, then. In Sweden, I've had some, I think was with 83, actually also 84 or 5. And there we just think, okay, this one is big. Then there's a variation, you say, on mealy red pole called whole belly. And they are often bigger and has a longer bill than other mealy red poles. But they are actually still in the same group here. So they, but in general, they look bigger and the bill longer. Somebody had like argued if it was another taxa, another subspecies, but it's mealy red poles. Then there's the pale one, maybe the one that the crew took, same structure like rostrata. And then Q's, and that is Ixalipus. So this is the Arctic red poles, these two. That is, these ones is what we get. And what you should be aware of here is actually more about the bill. So bill, can you see, is on average shorter than on both mealy and lesser, actually. That's why it looks so short, the bill. And horny manny is just the biggest one of them all. So if you have like a motherfucking big Arctic redpoll, oh shit, this is big. Then like a bullfinch big, then maybe we should be extra careful with some pictures. Probably not like totally impossible with a horny manny. Yeah. Then I think I will talk a little bit about. Now we'll take some pictures. We don't take pictures. We'll look at some pictures I will first show you some, and then afterwards, then you just get an impression of the one picture of a bird in profile, and then you just get out from that impression, then write down for yourself what taxa you think it belongs to. And that is just to have an idea also about what you're thinking when you see it. Flammea, mealy redpoll, the bill, quite long and powerful. This little yellowish tone to the brown on the back. Okay, that is also unusually bill, that one. Maybe it's the angle. It looked like somebody had put the bill on the bill. Quickly about sexing, then I can say that, yeah, this is also a Flammea mealy redpoll. So here it actually have lost a little bit of its brownness. And that is because it's an early spring bird. So then it gets more white underneath, then lose some of the brown tones. You can still see here, especially on the scapulars, there's more there's it's brown, not like in an Arctic redpoll where it has this cream color. But they get more whitish on it because they get worn. This is actually an adult male. So it's very, here you see if the birds are red on the breast, then it's always an adult male, yes. So don't put first years and stuff like that. Then there are some that has very faintly red actually, even though that they are adult. And then it can be a little, I think the Icelandic one, we thought, okay, maybe this is an adult, but it has only a trifle of, or was that the Chinese one, the one from China? Maybe that one actually only had a little bit of red on the breast, it was an adult. Then is it a female with a little bit, old female, or I don't know, that is a little bit. Also, if you have an Arctic warbler, Arctic redpoll, then it get more like pink on the breast, like, yeah, rosa, kind of. So that can be very hard to see. Then we have some lesser redpolls where it's like, okay, this is like more red than other colors. See if we can find male 2+ here. Yeah. Looks small headed. That was actually the one with the white undertail. No, this is Cabaret. But you're right, it has like kind of a little yellowish tone, but I think this is because it's from, when was from? Yeah, this is actually from May. Then usually the Flammea is gone also. But they can have very strong red colors, these lesser adult males. right, the coloration here, yeah, it just varies, like. But here the head and the bill is quite smallish. A few Arctic. That was the one we had. And take a close up. This is one of the same ones from the presentation. See this cream coloration, faint streaks to the flank, bill short. Ah, sweet position. Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah. Then this about like the feathers, like the white tips to the covers. So if they have molted covers, then often they get a brown or cream coloration. If it's juvenile feathers that's unmolted, then they often will be white. But on a lesser redpoll, they are more browner, so they also tend to have more brown tone in the lesser covers, even on juvenile feathers. But that you can use when aging them also. But because the feathers are more brown, then it's actually also more difficult to find the molt limits on a lesser redpoll. I'll show you one more picture of an Arctic. Has a little more streak on the rump. Yellowish. A cream coloration to the back, not brown area. So like often a mealy redpoll would have some more like brown here, but here's the same coloration all over. Short bill, little eye, head looks big on the bird. Bulky. You can see some of the flanks. Faint flanks. That is actually one of those with quite a lot of streaks on the undertail covers. Yeah, okay. I'll show you four birds. And then you just write down the impression of what you get. So it's also a little bit here, you don't get like the measurements of the bird. So we just you just give an impression of it. And then we can discuss it afterwards. This is an Arctic ixodipus. So the flanks are faintly streaked. The coloration here can maybe be a little bit uneasy to assess. But bill short, eye little in the big face, okay? This is a mealy. Aflamere. Yeah. So, and this actually, it looks like an adult male. It has some red here, so, yeah. And this has get a little worn on the feathers, so even though it's white here, on the greater covers, it's still an adult. Maybe because it has, yeah, by wear, it went a little more white. Strong, long bill. Head different from, not bulky as in a Arctic redpoll. It's not brown here in this area. It has some witty undertones making it a little more yellowish. Yeah. Okay. This is, I just tell you what it is. It's an Arctic, it's an ixodipus. Yeah. A young bird. And can you see, somebody has taken the head of another bird and put it on here. Like, yeah, this one, the head really look huge.
And the eyes are huge.
Yeah. This is a lesser cabaret. Brown, okay? Maybe a female, but we don't do that when it's second year birds. Or first year birds. they tend to have not a little more like not so much pronounced red on the head here. Lesser like the bill leg look a little like not as tall as on the other taxa. Brown and like beige, a lot of beige brown tone here to the breast. And if it was double the size, maybe it could look like a rostrata. But you can actually see the flanks on the rostratas, they are bigger than on a cabaret also. Okay. Here is a lot of information. No, so sexing to start with. We have some birds where, so if it's adult birds, are they red on the breast? Then it's a male. Are they not? Then it's a female. Then there's a few that's maybe a little bit into, but in general, that is how we do. With the young birds, then some females actually show not so much red here. It's more, it has a yellowish tone in the front of the head, and they are probably females, but we are not certain about it. So young birds we don't sex unless there are some red in the rump, a little bit of red in the rump, or a little bit around the bill or the breast. Then we put males on them. Aging, then the tail, so more narrow and pointy on juvenile tail feathers, and more rounded and broader on post breeding. They only molt, the adult molt complete in the summer, and young molt have a partial molt in the summer, no winter molt. So a molt limit is the same as a young bird. The extent of the molt, so many molts, some greater covers, but some doesn't. So they keep all the greater covers juvenile. There you need to look for the molt limits in median and lesser covers. In general, then Flamia, if we take those two taxa, Flamia and Cabra, then Flamia tends to molt a little more covers in the post-juvenile molt compared to Cabra. In general, so, but many birds you will find the molt limit in greater coverts, also in lesser, also in lesser redpoll, yeah. And in general, the molt limits in the wing are a trifle more difficult to find in lesser redpoll, I would say, because the feathers are more brown. So the juvenile feathers can still have some brown in the tips of the coverts. That makes it a little more difficult. So it's the center color you go for there. I'll show you Arctic warbler. Warbler. I'm thinking about that all the time. What catch you? We have caught an Arctic warbler some years ago. Arctic redpoll. So Ex Libris. I think they follow those who have caught here. Follows. They tend to be like Flamia, in extent of the post-juvenile molt. So, good. Now you will get a few birds where you will make a molt card on, and those back home on other bird observatory who has listened to this, welcome to make a molt card also. And then we go them together afterwards, okay? Yes? This is the wing of a lesser redpoll. You are welcome to make molt card on this. Yes, you have now done some molt cards. I know I haven't showed you examples of tail feathers yet, but I can do that at the end. So right now it was you did some molt card on the wings. Wrote down which generations the different feathers belongs to, and this was the first one. this lesser red polar cabaret. Somebody would like to come with a suggestion here? Yeah? Good. What did you find? It is a first year bird, yes.
And so there's a mode limit in the greater covers.
Yeah, the mode limit, yeah.
Oh.
Yes, no, continue.
And the four innermost are post-juvenile.
Yeah. Four innermost post-juvenile, rest juvenile. Yeah.
And I also think that the first two tertials are post-juvenile.
Yes, so mode limit here. Yeah. Two post-juvenile, rest is juvenile. I agree. So more brownish centered, here dark centered, more coloration here to the tips. The same here. They are whitish, the tips here. Here they have more coloration on the new ones. Then the center color change. So darker centered color here and browner centered here. And lesser and median are molted. They are post juvenile too. And the rest, alula, primary cross juvenile. And carpel is out here. It's not easy to see, but I would guess it's juvenile. Yes? Everybody is agreeing?
Yep.
Yes? Good. Yep. And here, this one. Another lesser redpoll.
It's an adult because it's growing a secondary.
Yes, and it's in autumn, so it's a second calendar year plus. And you are sharp. Christina, you could see there was a secondary growing, so it's
the other one.
What is this one, you mean?
Oh, no.
1, 2, 3 tertials, and then there's one underneath. Yes. Yeah. So, yeah. And that is because it's in the end of its post-breeding molt, so all feathers are post-breeding. Dark-centered, all of them, a lot of buff tips, brown tips to all the feathers. Yeah? Mm-hmm. The same coloration on it. Then we have a mealy redpoll, that's the last one. Yeah?
First year.
Yeah.
And the there's a mode limit in the tertials, I think.
Yeah, okay. What did you say, Jeppe?
I would say no.
I think also they're juvenile, actually. Yeah. It fits with the rest of the bird. Yeah? What about the greater coverts?
Juvenile.
They are all juvenile. Oh. And if they all greater coverts are juvenile, then there's good chance that the tertials are also juvenile, I would say.
But then in the median, there's a
molt. If it had molt limit in greater coverts or also in here or out here, then there's a bigger chance they also have molt. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. What about the median coverts? Yes, the mode limit is here. Post-juvenile, juvenile. So now I said before this that the cabaret usually mode less coverts in a post-juvenile mold than Flamier does. But here is the opposite on the examples that I found here. So here the mode limit is down in the median coverts on the Flamier, but it wasn't greater coverts in cabaret.
Yeah.
So, but if we take like 100 birds, then a lesser would have molted a little less covers than a Flamier. Yeah? You see my white tips here, because they got worn, then they are less colored. The tips, brown centered. So less than half of the median are post-juvenile, the rest of the wing juvenile. Yes? Okay, then I'll just show you a little bit. I can just show you a little bit of the tail feathers, maybe. This is actually an adult tail. You could say, okay, this one actually has some, it's a little pointy. So it's not always so easy. This one looks more rounded out here. But this is a fully post-breeding tail. Here we can see it's an adult male. Yeah, yes. Here's a first year. Tail of a first year. So the difference is not always super obvious. This is a fully juvenile tail. And we can take a mealy redpoll here. That's a little more easy. Fully juvenile tail. An adult male mealy. This is more obvious than the lesser we had before, but it's the same. They were also post-breeding, so. Yes, good. Now we just need a lot of red pulls.
Yeah. Thank you, Dima.
Yeah, thank you.